is better to lower blood cholesterol and a risk of heart disease.
The latest research is showing that it's not a matter of reducing oil consumption altogether, but choosing the light fats in the right amounts. And Yvonne helps us understand this better in the second of a three-part series on health. With greater research into the fats we consume, our understanding of what's good and bad for us is slowly shifting.
All fatty acids have function, important function in the cell. That means bad do not exist. The only thing we fear is the excess of someone, of some of them. Okay? You have to switch to the old position, bad or good, to the new position, how much of which.
This debunks the myth that all saturated fats found in meat, dairy, and some plant products are bad for us. All along, we've steered clear of these to reduce our risk of heart disease and stroke. But Professor Legrand believes there are types of saturated fats we can benefit from because of its high concentration of medium-chain fatty acids. These are resistant to high heat and can provide the body with a quick source of energy. Overall, a fat taken in the right amounts and including saturated fat can provide essential fatty acids our body can't produce. It helps the body absorb vitamins A, S, E, and K. And fats can play a big role in helping to manage our moods, stay on top of our mental game, and yes, control our weight. Diets too low in fat could trigger cravings, lead to a vitamin deficiency, and affect physical and psychological growth among children.
So there's such a wide range of oils to choose from. I'm here with a nutritionist, Mr. T. Mr. T, can you tell me, how do you choose the right oil?
Actually, when we're choosing the right oil, it depends on the way of your cooking. Because actually, for normal Singaporean cooking, right, we have actually three types of cooking. Normal stir frying, the deep frying, as well as the dressing. Yeah, so it really depends on how your cooking style, like choosing the right oil for the right cooking style will be the one healthy choice. In terms of cooking, if you are going for deep frying, probably you should go for saturated fat, because saturated fat doesn't break down. You actually get saturated fat into your body. Your body know how to handle it. But if you use unsaturated fat for deep frying, it's going to break down them into small chain fatty acid, and it can actually increase the inflammation reaction in your body, which is not so good.
You see, some oils can withstand a higher temperature than others. They have a higher smoke point. A fat is no longer good for consumption after it has exceeded its smoke point and has begun to break down. So choose the right oils and don't overheat them.
To know too, what actually goes into vegetable cooking oil, because there's various ingredients, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. Because cooking oil itself, it doesn't mean anything. It just means that the ingredients actually come from plant. So you really need to go into the ingredients section to look at it. For example, like this product, they actually have palm oilin and soybean oil. So the palm oilin will be the base product of this oil, so it's mainly for deep frying purpose.
And it helps it withstand high temperatures.
Yeah, it withstand high temperatures.
Okay, but is it good for us?
Well, if you take a lot of it, it won't be good for you, but if you just go for deep frying occasionally for your kids or your family, that would be the one choice.
Well, take a look at these. These are all oils used for salads. They're generally not used for cooking. We've got macadamia oil, blended seed oil, coconut oil, grapeseed oil, and then got a whole range of olive oils down here. How do we tell the difference between all of these in terms of how healthy they are?
I think olive oil become very popular. Everyone go for the healthy choice of olive oil. In fact, olive oil, it also really depends on how you use the olive oil for. Because technically speaking, for example, like things like this, okay, this is what we call as a classic olive oil. Okay, you can go for the sauces, roasting, grilling. It can withstand a little bit of heat for cooking. Okay, but when we look at when a lot of people going for this extra virgin olive oil mainly means that this olive oil goes through very little of processing. It's mainly used for dressing, marinades, or dips. It shouldn't go into any cooking. It's purely for dressing purpose. Extra light olive oil actually goes through a few more stages of processing, so it is good for sauteing, frying, and baking. So this olive oil can go for cooking. Yeah, this one can go through some heat treatment to cook your food.
And what about nutritional benefits?
Nutritional benefits, usually we get unsaturated fat mainly from the vegetable oil, except from the palm oil and coconut oil. So you get the unsaturated fat to go into your body. Usually it will be helpful to increase your good cholesterol, reduce your bad cholesterol, and also some of the 3 or naturally they contain omega 3. It is very good for inflammation control.
And the difference between polyunsaturated and monounsaturated?
Polyunsaturated will be mainly on the chemical structure in it. Polyunsaturated means that there are more double bonds inside. Monounsaturated, fat, there's only one double bond inside. In terms of their health benefit, they are quite similar in fact.
Some examples of polyunsaturated fats include soybean oil, safflower oil, and fat found in salmon, tuna, and sardines. Monounsaturated fat can be found in olive oil, canola oil, sunflower oil, sesame oil, avocados, and nuts.
Now, there's a few of these bottles state that they're trans fat free. Is that good or bad for us?
Actually, trans fat is not good for our health.
Why is that?
Yeah, it actually increases our bad cholesterol, it reduces our good cholesterol, and in long term, we're actually stuck in our blood vessels and causing a lot of heart diseases, stroke problems.
Well, that's interesting. I spoke to a chemist the other day, and she actually told us where trans fats come from. Take a listen.
They're all that we're using for cooking, vegetable oil. They are very full of unsaturated fatty acids, and if we leave it like that, then it will become rancid very quickly. So what the industry used to do is to hydrogenate it. So when they hydrogenate it, but they don't fully hydrogenate it, then it will become all saturated. Right? So they only partially hydrogenate it, and that's when the problem comes, that even though it's not their intention to produce the trans fatty acids, but it is produced in the process of partial hydrogenation.
So it looks like we should check labels to see whether they're trans fat free. It's not only oils though that contain trans fats, right?
Usually trans fat will be used in processed food and packaged food. Yeah, so usually we don't really see much of trans fat in the oil, but actually on something like high heat treated products like biscuits, bakeries, or even chips.
Trans fats can enhance the flavor, texture, and shelf life of foods.
Now, a lot of products actually state that they're trans fat free, but there's another way of telling whether products contain trans fat, right?
Yeah, when you look at the ingredients, if it's stated that it is hydrogenated fats, partially hydrogenated fats, or even shortening, it actually shows that it contains trans fat inside.
Okay, so steer clear of these.
Yes.
Correct.
Yeah.
High in cholesterol, does that necessarily translate to high cholesterol in our bodies if we eat them?
Actually, cholesterol in our bodies is made by our liver. So 1/3 of the cholesterol is coming from our food. If you eat a lot of them, yeah, your body will build more cholesterol for you. So in terms of translation, yes it is. If you eat a lot of cholesterol, then you will have high cholesterol in your body.
Right, so there is a way of eating corn with less cholesterol, isn't there?
Yes, if you remove the internal organs out from the prawns, the black strips at the back of the prawns, that's the internal organ that enters inside. So if you remove all of them, yeah, you'll get less cholesterol, but a lot of people don't like that. These are actually saturated fats. So when it goes into your body, well, it can turn into cholesterol. If you are eating in moderate, once in a while occasionally, they are still okay. But if you take it as your favorite food, it's going to be very unhealthy.
So what kind of fat is in butter versus margarine?
Butter itself is mainly come from dairy source, so it will be mainly saturated fat inside. Margarine is mainly a treated kind of fats coming from plant source. So butter itself it contains saturated fat and cholesterol. Margarine, which most of the time it doesn't contain cholesterol.
Okay, and within the range of margarine that you can get, is there a healthier option?
Yes, because margarine there are two types. One is a soft margarine and the other one is a hard margarine. Hard margarine, usually the process that goes through will be the hydrogenation, which contains a lot of trans fat. But soft margarine, most of the time they don't really go through a hydrogenation process, which is a healthier choice.
And a fat-free label doesn't mean you can eat all you want without consequences to your waistline. Many fat-free foods are high in sugar, refined carbohydrates, and calories. Well, that's a lot to take in about fats and oils, but if you're going to remember three things today, here are some take-home tips. Choose your fats wisely and in the right amounts. Use the right oil for the right purpose. And finally, avoid trans fats by checking your food labels thoroughly.
And this is just nice because in the short while we're going to be talking more about food and Singapore's hawker food. I think in the past recent times a bit of debate about how it's becoming a bit of a dying art because, you know, the hawkers move on, the young generation doesn't want to quite take on